Here's a piece of obscure vintage TV equipment that I bet you've never seen or heard of before. The Microscan. It's in this little metal enclosure with just one knob on the front labeled Tune and the trademarked Microscan logo. It has this permanently attached Condor Trans-X 12-volt AC transformer made in Taiwan. And some of the paint is chipped off, revealing some rust underneath. On the back of the cabinet, it says Made in USA by Innovision. And at some point, somebody tried to sell this for 50 cents, or is that 0.50 cents? In which case, I wonder what they got for the other half of a penny. On the rear, it has an MW on-off switch, and three F-type connectors labeled TV antenna, TV set, and MW. Considering that the logo on the front shows a parabolic dish antenna, and the name of it is Microscan, that MW most likely stands for microwave, which probably means this has something to do with satellite TV, in the early years of which the terms microwave and satellite were used interchangeably, because every satellite dish is a microwave dish. It just happens to be pointed up at the sky rather than at a terrestrial transmitter. Unfortunately, trying to search for information about this Microscan device yielded nothing conclusive. There was a brand of parabolic dish antennas called Microscan, but the logo doesn't match. And the trademark for that Microscan was registered to High Frontier Corporation of Phoenix, Arizona, not Innovision. And in the early 1980s, there were several stores in the Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania area called Microscan, selling satellite TV equipment, but that also doesn't seem to have anything to do with Innovision or the Microscan device I have. And while I doubt many of these were made, and this is obviously an off-the-shelf enclosure and knob, exactly like what you could have bought at Radio Shack for a few bucks, I don't think you can call this homemade, because whoever did make it gave themselves a company name, they claimed a trademark on the product name, they gave it a nice-looking silkscreen logo, and they riveted the cabinet shut to keep people like me from opening it up to see what's inside. Of course, there are ways around that. But first, I want to connect the Microscan to a TV to see if I can get it to do anything interesting, even without having a satellite dish connected to it. As a first test, I have the RF output of a VCR connected to the TV antenna input of the Microscan, and then the Microscan's output connected to the antenna input of a TV, just to see if it can pass through a signal in what should be a bypass mode when the Microscan is turned off.
And that's absolutely false. In Florida versus Aquilera, the public got a chance to see that radar really isn't infallible. The equipment itself is something.
And indeed it does, because with the VCR playing a tape about something related to satellite, radar, it is passing through the Microscan to the TV when the Microscan is turned off. But when I turn the Microscan on, I get snow on the TV.
Traffic radar has been in use for more than 30 years.
But interestingly, with the VCR's RF output set to channel 4 rather than channel 3, which I was using previously, now when I flip the switch on the Microscan, the signal on the TV gets worse, but is still visible. Now I want to try connecting a signal source to the MW input of the Microscan, and to do that, I have this Sony Hi8 Handycam with this little RF modulator connected to it, which I can easily connect to that MW input on the back of the Microscan, and see what happens when I try that. And to make it interesting, I'm going to have the RF output of both the VCR and the Handycam set to channel 3. In some models, the police radar And now with the microscan turned off, I see the output of the VCR. And if I turn it on, I see the output of the Handycam. Now there is some lines and interference in the picture due to both sources being on the same channel, but it does serve as a switcher between them. And now with only the Handycam connected to the microscan and it turned on, I don't see any difference in the picture on the TV depending on how I'm adjusting the tuning control on the microscan. It doesn't seem to make any difference, but if I turn the microscan off, the picture quality on the TV is noticeably worse. So maybe this is at least serving as some kind of signal amplifier to boost the output of whatever device you have it connected to.
All two-piece units were affected by panning the beam through the display console.
It's the same thing with the output of the VCR connected to the MW input of the microscan. The signal is passed through to the TV, perhaps boosted but otherwise unmodified regardless of the position of its tuning control. So the results of that testing blew out of the water my first theory about the purpose of the microscan, and that is it might have been a very early and simplistic form of satellite TV receiver. Like the SatTech R2B from 1982, which doesn't look a whole lot more professional than the microscan, and is also obviously packaged in an off-the-shelf hobby enclosure, but claimed to be the first low-cost volume production satellite TV receiver. But if the microscan was serving that purpose, it would be tuning in frequencies in the 3 to 4 GHz range and converting them down to ordinary VHF channels for connecting to a TV, rather than just passing through signals that already exist on VHF without modifying their frequency. After drilling out 3 rivets, including one which was just actually grounding the circuit board to the case and not actually holding on the cover, oops, I'm inside. And part of its circuitry is actually just a switch box, because when you have the MW switch in the off position, it shorts together the 2 contacts on the right, which is connecting the TV antenna input directly to the TV set output. And when you have the MW switch in the on position, part of it is directly connecting the MW input through the switch to the TV set output, but it also has this circuit path through a couple of capacitors here to the rest of the circuitry, which includes a 78M12 12-volt DC voltage regulator and these 2 big capacitors which have 1982 date codes on them. They're both Ritchie 470 microfarad 50-volt electrolytic capacitors. And sure enough, as soon as I plug it in, I get about 14 volts coming out of the MW jack, even with the switch in the off position. That was one of my thoughts all along, that this device doesn't actually do much on its own except serve as a switch box and also a power supply, sending that DC voltage through the feed line to more circuitry connected directly to the back of the satellite dish. Which means this green blob, which I initially thought was a capacitor, must be something else, like an inductor. Otherwise, it would be blocking that voltage from getting to the MW jack. But it does have this capacitor blocking the voltage from getting to the TV set output. To prevent that voltage from backfeeding into your TV set, even though most video devices do have a blocking capacitor on their antenna inputs. And in case you're wondering what the tuning knob does on the front of the microscan, with it set to the middle position, it's putting out about 14.5 volts. And with the knob turned all the way to the right, that drops down to around 12 volts. And with it turned all the way to the left, it increases to about 16.2 volts. So I don't know how you can call this tuning something, but that's what it does. It just adjusts the voltage of the power supply. In the October 1982 issue of Radio Electronics magazine, I found this ad for a 2.3 GHz microwave down converter system used by ham radio operators. So this is for terrestrial microwave use, not satellite. You put the transmitter somewhere high up, like on a tower or a tall building or a hilltop, and the receiver has to be pretty much within direct line of sight, because at that frequency, even the leaves of a tree can block the signal. In this case, they're using a Yagi antenna, not as effective as a parabolic dish antenna, but easier to make yourself out of ordinary hardware. And the power supply for this system is very similar to the microscan device I have, including a transformer, a tuning knob on the front, and three F connectors on the back, but it's a little bit more fancy because it also has a fine tuning control, and it has a wood grain cabinet. So that seems to be what this microscan device is, the power supply for a terrestrial point-to-point microwave TV down converter used by ham radio operators in the early 1980s. And that certainly fits in with its homemade or small-scale production appearance and design. And as for what purpose the microscan can serve in this day and age, it at least makes a nifty little variable regulated 12 to 16 volt power supply. Even if my dreams of connecting it to a big ugly dish have been thwarted